In this lesson, our approach will be slightly different. Instead of creating a third display from scratch, we'll be building off the work our colleague has already done. We'll be taking a step back outside the PyVision display editor to perform some simple display management tasks. There exists a display we'd like to use and adapt for our purposes, but we need to either gain ownership of it or produce an editable copy to do so, as it has been marked read-only by our colleague. Originally adapted from an existing PyProcessBook file, this display focuses on an individual oil well and several of the KPIs we're interested in. But it still has some marks of its legacy origins that we'd like to modernize, while also introducing asset event tracking for further insight into our oil well's performance. Since this lesson touches on PyVision's support for visualizing events, it's important to understand just what an event frame is. In the real world, things happen, and we call these occurrences events. They may be planned, such as the transition between operator shifts, or they may be unplanned, such as an equipment outage that halts production entirely. Regardless of an event's nature, it takes place in time and typically has a clearly defined start and end. This start and end time frame our event and enable more accurate analysis within the bounds. Event frames therefore capture these events and information about them, enabling analysis of those events to determine root cause, operational impact, and mitigation strategies to employ in the future. Just as elements allow you to collect and store data about assets, event frames allow you to collect and store data about events.